Hello everyone, and welcome to The Sims Lore. Today, we're looking into the Tanner family and Roman's cooking rivalry with Len and Sosa.
Two portions of quail! How stupid does that look? You're one portion short, you f***ing donut!
So grab your snacks, because you're probably gonna get really hungry during this video, and let's find out who the winning chef is. Don't forget to subscribe and like this if you enjoyed it. Alright, let's get straight into the video. The Tanner household is made up of Roman and his wife Aya and their kids Ethan and Yuna. The household bio reads, "Four generations of cooking excellence define the Tanner family name, but now an upstart with a fancy pedigree has come to challenge the Tanners as the best chefs in town. Will Ethan's homegrown culinary skills triumph over the formal training of his nemesis?" The family lives at 96 Sonora Street in a three-bedroom, two-bathroom house called La Casa, whose description reads, "This one-level Spanish colonial house features a pool and a carport. It is the perfect family home for the perfect family. Fortunately, there is space to expand as the family grows." So like we always do, let's just walk into these Sims' house and completely invade their privacy. For entertainment purposes, of course. Their house looks very modest from the outside, like the description says, it's very Spanish colonial inspired. It also mentions there's plenty of space as the family grows, which is our first hint to a certain something. As you come in, there are lots of doors in the hallway. The dining room is to the right, and through the door from the dining room is the kitchen. Here we can see a baby high chair amongst the usual kitchen furniture. To the left of the entrance, there's the living room, equipped with two sofas and two armchairs, a desk, some bookshelves, and a fireplace. There's also a bathroom right next to the living room here. Through the first door at the end of the hall is the master bedroom, which also has access to the bathroom we just saw. Next to this bedroom is Ethan's bedroom. Here he has a stereo, a bookshelf, a desk with a computer, a guitar, a baseball, a football, and a PEXELS machine. Next to Ethan's room is Yuna's bedroom. She has plenty of toys, including a dollhouse, a bear, a little baker's oven, and a toy chest. She also has a dresser, a crib, and a potty. These could have been hers growing up, however the description I think hints to the family getting ready for another baby. Next to Yuna's room there's a second bathroom as well. Outside, the family has a pretty large pool, and even though they have a carport, they don't own a car. Let's firstly have a look at Roman Tanner. His bio reads, "Generally jolly Roman is an expert angler and an amateur guitar player. Roman is an adult and is a 4-star celebrity with the Scorpio star sign. He is a natural cook, childish, charismatic, and ambitious. He is missing one other trait, and that could be because he grew up poorly. His favorites are indie music, French toast, and the color aqua. Roman works as a chef de cuisine in the culinary career, where he's doing okay, but he would benefit from getting along with his co-workers a bit more. His relationships panel is huge, he has loads of friends, acquaintances, and distant friends as well. Again, not to bore you to death, I've picked the most important ones for the story. His relationship with his family is really good, he's in good standing with his wife and both his kids Yuna and Ethan. Roman is also good friends with his co-worker Palmer Hayes. He is distant friends with the Matt Lappins and Darren Dreamer, and he is acquaintances with his boss Jenny Gomez and co-worker Cornelius Van Deen. Roman is disliked with Lola Lancaster, which we've established is a social pariah at this stage. And he's also enemies with Lennon Sosa, who is his enemy due to their cooking rivalry, which we'll have a look at. Roman is a very skilled sim, having 2 skill points in charisma, 8 in cooking, 3 in fishing, 5 in gardening, and 1 in handiness. Roman's lifetime wish is to become the culinary librarian, which is easy to achieve when he learns every recipe. In his inventory, we can find the usual, but also a book titled The Life and Times of Mr. Chan. Despite Roman not having a trait, he has the hidden immunity to fire trait, which he passed down to his daughter Yuna. This means that one of Roman's parents or grandparents was a firefighter. Okay, now let's have a look at his wife, Aya Tanner. Her bio reads, "Once a journalist for a prominent food magazine, Aya came to do an article on Roman Tanner and ended up losing her heart to him. Aya is an adult and is a 1-star celebrity with the Pisces star sign. She is flirty, neat, family-oriented, artistic, and friendly. Her favourites are classical music, tofu dogs, and the colour blue. Aya works as a freelance writer in the journalism career, where she's doing really well. Just like her husband, Aya has a huge relationship panel. She pretty much has the same relationships as her husband, except she's not enemies with Lennon, they just dislike each other. She has one skill point in logic, charisma and cooking, and two skill points in writing. Her lifetime wish is to be surrounded by family, which she will be able to complete if the family has three more babies. In her inventory, we can find the usual, but also a laptop and two books titled French Toast, French Fries and French Kissing, and A Wall Between Us. Interestingly, Aya is pregnant at the start of the game, which brings her closer to achieving her lifetime wish. Okay, let's have a look at their teenage son, Ethan. His bio reads, "Though overall a good boy, Ethan has developed a deviant streak in his teenage years. Ethan is in his mid-teenage years and has the Aries star sign. He is virtuoso, good, hydrophobic, and a heavy sleeper. His favorites are Latin music, spaghetti with veggie sauce, and the color pink. Ethan is a C high school student and also works as a burial specialist in the local cemetery. He has one skill point in logic and two in guitar. In his inventory, we can find the usual, but also a guitar and a book titled How to Win at Video Games Without Really Trying. Ethan usually gets the Golden Tongue, Golden Fingers lifetime wish in my game due to his virtuoso trait. In regards to his bio, I think it's kind of weird that it mentions he developed a deviant streak since his traits don't really show that. It's also kind of creepy he works as a burial specialist in the cemetery as a teen. I don't know guys, I'm getting huge Joseph Doe vibes from this guy. Let's have a look at his sister, Yuna. Her bio reads, "Yuna is a precious child who is destined for greatness. Yuna is a child who has the Gemini star sign and she is good and ambitious." That's it? Shouldn't she have more traits? Has she just grown up poorly like her dad? Her favorites are indie music, goopy carbonara, and the color orange. Yuna is a C high school student and she has one skill point in logic. In her inventory, we can find the usual, but also a baseball and a book titled One Wolf, Two Wolves, Werewolf, Their Wolf. Interestingly, in the Sunwest graveyard, there is a grave with the name Astrid Tanner. Let's have a closer look at her. She weirdly has a bio which reads, "The former matriarch of Tanner clan." From this, we can assume she was Roman's mother, who passed away due to old age, even though she's not present in their family tree. Astrid had the Scorpio star sign and she was unflirty, brave, inappropriate, athletic, and artistic. Her favorites were classical music, grilled cheese sandwiches, and the color black. From her relationships panel, it can be presumed that she passed away before the Tanner kids were born since she seems to know her son and his wife a bit more than the rest of the family. Astrid's lifetime wish was to present the perfect aquarium, which she completed according to her tombstone. It's interesting that her bio, traits, or lifetime wish don't mention or hint to anything to do with cooking. This could be because Roman's dad was the cook in the family. Okay, so now that we looked at the Tanners, let's have a look at the beef between these two chefs. See what I did there? Okay, let's move on. The Tanners seem like a normal family. I find it interesting that at the start of the game, they only have 25,000 simoleons and live in a pretty modest house, considering Roman is a 4-star celebrity. Lennon, on the other hand, only has 20,000 simoleons in his household funds, he lives in a more expensive area of the town, and his assets are worth more. Also, he doesn't have two kids and one on the way. Oh wait, no, actually he does. I cover him and his soon-to-be baby mama in this video right here if you haven't seen it already. While we've already seen his house and know more details about him, I wanted to elaborate on his backstory a bit more. I think Lennon comes from money since he attended the Fromage Grill cooking school as mentioned in his household bio. I think at some stage, him and Roman were all friends considering they share similar friends. Lennon is closer to the Matlapins, whilst the Tanners are distant friends with them, which probably happened during the divide between the two. Even though it's said that both are rivals, Lennon wants to become a world-renowned chef, while Roman wants to learn every recipe there is. In terms of their jobs, well, Roman is well ahead of Lennon, being a chef de cuisine, while Lennon is a pastry chef. Regardless of this, neither of them can really advance easily within their careers if they don't come to some amicable agreement, which might happen, considering both of them are natural cooks and ambitious, so they would have a lot of common ground. Maybe with a baby on the way, Lennon can make a bit more space in his heart for more friends rather than collecting enemies now that he's about to become a dad. How do you guys play with these households? Let me know in the comments below. Alright guys, there you have it, lots of info on the beef in Lucky Palms. I'd like to thank my patrons Negative Dana, Papa Khan, Leo Thompson, Artsy Flashback, Nathan Lim, Caitlin Luigi, Mr. Netch, A Wild Kitty Cat, Kitachan the Arcane Archer, Carolyn, Andreas, Whitney, Hannah S., Amy Louise, Charlie, Libby Young, Perlog Anwil, and Brigitte Gill. Thank you guys so much for supporting my channel. That's it for today's video. Thank you all so much for watching. Please like the video if you enjoyed it and let me know your theories in the comments below. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram for more lore and updates. I'll see you in my next video. Bye!